and live in session, and this is probably what I was hinting at, no offence to the rest of the fantastic items we've got, but live in session, we've got the Cardiacs. I know. And this just came about a couple of weeks ago, if I'm honest. Somebody sent me through Tim's email address. He had a couple of backs and forths, and it worked. And I've been in listening to him doing the deed earlier, and he's absolutely, quite simply, fantastic. And if they can manage it, they're going to do four tunes today rather than three, because it is remarkable stuff. In fact, they're one of them bands that when they're playing, you just, you marvel at it, but you also, when it finishes, you just laugh. Well, when I say you laugh, I mean me, and I think it's because I'm such a bad musician that I just can't even comprehend where they're coming from. But it sounded fantastic, so yeah, in around about 5 minutes' time, the Cardiacs will be in this room and playing with us, so that is marvellous, is it not? And having been joined in the studio by the Cardiacs, who are under no pressure whatsoever to deliver, as they've just said. Hello, people.
Hey.
Hi. Hello.
How are you doing?
Thank you.
Does that mean good?
Thank you. Yeah, good.
Yeah, good.
Frightened.
Well. You're not frightened. You can't be frightened. You're the Cardiacs. You've been doing this for how many? 29 years, is it?
Frightened.
All right, you're frightening me now then, Tim. All right, so even more frightening, Tim. Are you the mouthpiece for the band today? Are you going to be doing all the talking?
Bit scared.
Bit scared, or somebody come in and give him a love. Michelle, come and give him a love, will you? She's coming as well, you know.
I'm fine.
There you go, you see.
I'm good.
It's just that brimming with sexuality. He was frightened before. Blimey, you should see him now. Anyway, all right then. So, Tim, would you like to introduce the rest of the band to us, please?
Why do that?
Because people need to know the names of the talented individuals who are going to be throwing forth some marvellous music today.
Well, everyone.
Right, okay, Tim is on guitar and vocals, Jim is on bass and vocals, Bob is on drums, and Carvis is on, very nice, is that a country gentleman?
White Falcon.
White Falcon. Shut up, Carvis. Oh, excellent. Right, okay then, you're going to play a tune for us now, aren't you?
Yeah, this is one that we used to play when we were babies, when we were about 16. From about 1978 or something like that, because it's on an album that we've just put out of all these old tunes that we dug up for fun.
Yes, well, you've got Volume 1, Volume 2, and you've also got the Cardiacs' Greatest Hits, which are all current releases, these, aren't they? But of old stuff.
All Greatest Hits. No, this is just one of the old tunes that we used to play. We just dug it up for a giggle to see what they are like now.
Oh,
and this
right,
is
okay.
One of them. This is all called
right.
Hope Day.
Smash it. All right, this is the Cardiacs in session and Hope Day.
That's right. Isn't it, Jimmy?
See what the fuss is about myself. Absolutely brilliant, that, fellas. Mind-boggling to watch and well, mind-boggling to listen to as well. Thank you very much indeed for that. Now then, you're not getting away that easily. Are you genuinely a bit nervous, Tim, or not?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you? Fair enough. When was the last time that you did a live session like this?
Don't know. 5 years ago, something.
Was it? Right, okay. So you don't do it that often?
No.
No. Well,
it's a funny situation, isn't it, being here and you're sitting there looking at us?
It is, yeah, it's an awful situation.
Your eye.
Yes, I know, I will disappear under the desk in future, but it is a weird one.
I know it's there, I know that your eye is under the desk.
Well, I'll poke him out just for you, if you like. What? Oh, a bit of technology going mad there. Oh.
Carver's freaked out.
I didn't freak
out. Everybody listening on the radio, Carver's just freaked out.
Freaked out.
Bob! I don't freak out, man.
I think this is between me and Carver's, Mark. Yeah?
Is he? Right, okay, yeah, all right. Yeah.
Carver's freaked out, everyone listening.
You don't want to know that, do you?
No way.
Right, no, he didn't. Yes, I'm keeping out of it. All right, then.
You saw it was him.
You freaked out!
It was him.
He freaked out completely. It's just unbelievable. It's just not professional, is it? Chris, come and sort him out. Security!
He freaked out.
Right, on that note, I think we should probably put a trail on before a fight breaks out in the studio, and you're going to hear some more great music coming up. We're spoiling you today, you know. I've been rejoined in the studio. They've had a fracas, a minor fracas outside, and now Carvis has got a black eye, but I think it's all sorted. So, well sorted, Tim. Yeah.
It's just what you do, isn't
it? It is, when you're in bands. It's just, there's no way around it. You've got to beat somebody up every now and then, haven't you?
I didn't hit him. I made Jim hit him.
Did you? Jim's a big one. Funnily enough,
it didn't really hurt much.
It hurt. I saw you blub.
Oh, he blubbed, did he?
I wasn't blubbing.
I'm just looking here now then. Oh, well, somebody has said, you know, your session sounds great. We've had all the e-miders in. He does it. People, there's one person who said, oh, please put something on more suitable for a Saturday afternoon. What's more suitable than that? I ask you. But we've got a lot of people come out in your favour. But somebody did say, yes, good call. Somebody did say that they hope that Jim doesn't get beat up again. Now, what's that all about?
I don't think it's worth going into that, really.
No, it's not, is it? No. Well, I won't then, because I'm a consummate professional.
I wouldn't beat him up.
No, you wouldn't.
Would you?
Me, personally.
You offered earlier.
I did
when
offer
the news
earlier.
Was on.
Yeah, when the news was on, but that was sort of comedic.
I think you'd
Can
win.
We do it afterwards, naked, as God intended?
Women in love kind of thing, Oliver Reed and Alan Bates.
Kind of, without the fire.
If we can get some mud together, then that might be worth watching.
Do we have to?
Michelle, go and get me some mud now! Right, okay, so, Tim, we were talking about this, we were discussing dates and how scary they can be, but it was 9 years ago that you came into this building and did a session for Marc Radcliffe and I. He hasn't got dandruff, really. So what have you been doing with yourself? Because you go into hibernation, don't you? The cardiacs come out to play every now and then, but you're not a constant, are you?
Well, there's no hurry, is there? You know, we do things, we put a record out, a few years pass, we put another record out. We're working on a new record now, that'll be out next year.
Right.
These things happen. There's no hurry.
No, absolutely. Well, I would again discuss you formed in the end of 1976, which was kind of, you know, the dying throes of prog rock and the start of punk rock. And you seem to have married them both together, don't you?
It's all tunes, isn't it? It's pop, isn't it? It's four guitars and a loud drum set. We turn it up really loud so that it distorts like this.
Oh, yeah.
And that's pop, isn't it?
It is pop music. No, I agree with you completely. What were you listening to before punk broke, though?
Probably prog.
Probably.
It's a funny word, though, isn't it? Because it's just all tunes. I like all kinds of tunes. I used to listen to country tunes, pop tunes. You played that Roxy Music one earlier. That's one of my favourite tunes in the whole world, Street Life.
Yeah. Oh, you can
It's
see,
all tunes. It's all tunes.
You can see a bit of Roxy Music in there, but I can't see much Tammy Wynette.
Why? Look at his guitar. Look at his expensive guitar.
All right, then.
How
you
country
win.
Is that?
Go on, man.
Tammy's
go on,
nice man. With a cup of tea and a nice
Shut
crispy.
Up, Jim.
Right, okay. I thought, you know what, I was saying the other day, we thought that the Reed brothers out of the Jesus and Mary Chain were the prototype for the Gallagher brothers, but obviously not. Anyway, are you going to do a tune for us now? I hope so.
Yeah, it's another old one that we used to play when we were babies. This one probably from about 1977.
Right, okay.
And it's on those garage concert albums that we've put out that you can only get on our website. They're not going to the shops, they're not allowed.
Right, okay. What is the website address?
Oh, cardiacs.com.
Easy.
Yeah,
right.
Easy.
Okay, all right then. This is a cardiacs in session. Brace yourselves, everyone.
As cold as can be in an English sea, this one's called.
Great stuff. Absolutely remarkable. That is as cold as can be in an English sea. The Cardiacs live in session. Some email that's coming through. Can you tell Tim Smith that we think he's marvellous and love him very much from Sarah Dobinson and Claire Roach? No offence to the rest of you, of course. I'm in heaven. Long live Cardiacs, says Mark in Cardiff. Cardiacs track made me and my family slump to the ground in awe, where we still are, twitching in the torrent of joy that hangs in the air, says Dr. Fitzgerald. Do you know that person? Probably not. Cardiac's fantastic. Can you ask where Sarah the sax player is? She was a bonny one, says Kevin and Chris, the Gladdock twins. Where is she?
In the woods with snails and things.
She's nice place to be. Strange.
Yeah.
She'll have a dab radio with her, you know, a little portable. Everybody does, you know.
Snails, radios.
She doesn't need one. I think she just picks it up anyway.
She communicates, does she? Through the ether.
She's a witch.
Yeah, yeah. Witchy Sarah.
Oh, is she? Oh, yeah. It's getting scary now. Tell you what, it's good, though. We've had a little bit of a conversation and no fight. And the time is now around about 19 minutes past two, and I've been rejoined in the studio by the Cardiacs. Hello, once again.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, now, did you notice there was an extra voice in there? I'm sure you did. And we're talking now of Sharon Saddington. That's your right name, isn't it?
It's Fortnum now, but it was Saddington.
Saddington. Oh, really? It's Fortnum now because she shamefully married some bloke with only four toes on his foot.
It's unbelievable, isn't it? You know, you just can't get the staff. And you're also a member of the North Sea Radio Orchestra, aren't you? We played on Minter, do you believe, a while ago.
That's right.
So you're, how many bands are you in?
Three altogether.
As you? Well,
yeah. Little country trio as well.
Really? Well, by the end of the day, there'll be more, I'm sure. There'll be queuing up outside the door.
Hopefully.
Now then, you are doing a tour. You're on the 6th of November, you're at Brighton Concord 2, 7th Portsmouth Wedgwood Rooms, rather, 8th Oxford Zodiac, 9th Northampton Soundhouse, and 11th London Astoria. That's right, isn't it?
That's right.
We'll plug them all again later. We have this thing every now and then that raises its head in this programme, the Bog-Eyed Band Club. Now, I have to, you know, to become a member, you have to get up at an ungodly hour and make the effort to get here. And I have to say, was it 5:30 when you set off today?
Yeah.
It was, wasn't it?
We were up before 5 there.
Now, don't start that. The rules are when you leave the house, and it was funny because I said before, the winners of this so far, the Dawn of the Replicants, who got up at 4:30 to get here from Gala Shields, and Tim went, that's typical, we never win anything. But, you've won the hearts and minds.
It's healthy to get up early. Sleep is for sluggerbeds.
Absolutely. You a drinker, Tim? Do you drink dirty beer?
Oh, boy.
Yeah. I'll take that as a yes. Well, you don't get up early then, do you? The two don't mix, do they?
Well, you get up early, you can drink more.
Ah, that's a philosophy. Steve, Dave, I don't know if it's Steve and Dave or Steve, Dave. Hi, Mark. Cardiacs are sounding amazing. Thanks for putting on the best band in the world. Tell them I'll see him in Brighton. A huge cheer to Tim, Jim, Bob and Carvos, and of course Sharon now. Nice one, Mark. Great show, says Johnny Karma. Nancy, you know Johnny?
Yeah.
Oh, the joys of wondrous sounds. I am loving this as I eat my biscuit lovingly. Nancy, do you know Nancy?
I know our Nancy, but she lives in Canada.
Doesn't
it
like
could
biscuits.
Be, you know. The technology takes this programme all over the world.
She likes cookies, though.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, yeah,
cookies,
sure
biscuits, what's the difference?
Well,
the same
in Canada,
thing.
They call them cookies.
Cookies, biscuits, so what?
No, he's right. Carvers, he's right. Over there, they don't call them biscuits. He wouldn't even know what they're on about.
You just sided with him. You know what we're going to have to go through now all day? Thanks
what?
A lot for that. Cheers.
Yeah, no bother. I'll do it again in a bit. There'll be another Barney. John's been on. Such a joy to hear the Cardiacs on the radio. Please say thanks to the band for blowing the cobwebs out of my ears for all those years. Long may they reign. You certainly will. Why don't you release your promo videos on DVD?
Dunno.
It's an answer. Right, okay then. To the point, as always. Right, so you're going to do another tune for us now? Would be rude not to.
You betcha.
Okay, what's this one called?
We'll Bleed Amen.
Excellent. All right then, Cardiacs live in session.
Everyone doing the end, don't even like this before.
Well, just amazing. Put that in the drawer with the rest of the amazing ones you did. That was really fantastic. That is a Cardiacs live in session, and we'll bleed amen, amen, whichever you choose. And boo-hoo, for the final time today, the Cardiacs have joined me in the studio. Good evening, good afternoon, good morning, whatever. I've lost track. Right, it is afternoon, you're right, yeah, I just looked at my watch. So we've had millions and millions, we've just counted, we've put an actual email account, and it was 4.5 million emails today. It's not bad, is it? I will tell you some. Mark from Salisbury, it's a bit funny listening to the Cardiacs coming out of my telly, but it's brilliant. Aren't you all a bit squashed in there? Not really. It's all right, it's plenty of room, isn't there? Last saw you backing up the Wild Hearts and you were amazing, says Rob and Becky. Michael's been on, my loyalty demands that I am listening to this with clean hands and shiny shoes. Good work, fella. And turned up very loud, of course, without a doubt. John, good on you for having Cardiacs on your radio. More people should have Cardiacs on the radio, and if they're not a radio station, they should build one. Antennas are quite basic items to build, and with the growing influx of the internet, there really is no excuse. So these people, plans afoot out there, by the sound of it. I first heard the Cardiacs on the Marc and Lard show whilst travelling home from work one night in 1996. I have no idea which song, though. They started me on the Cardiac Carousel. So, obviously.
It was 96 then.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems to be that case, yeah. You were right, weren't you? Yeah. You would be. Are you the Bill Wyman of the group? And now, don't take offence at that. I'm just saying that, there's always one person...
Your old girlfriend.
Yeah, I don't mean that. I mean, there's always one person in the band who's got a memory and who can remember things. And you were the guitar tech.
Yeah, you were the guitar tech, weren't you? Yeah.
Okay. All right, then. So, as I say, you're here for the last song today. Normally, you only sort of crowbar three songs out of the band, but today you've done four. So, you're very, very kind indeed. What are you going to do for us now?
Stoneage Dinosaurs.
Excellent. We'll be right back. brilliant stuff. Absolutely great. That's Tim, Jim, Bob, Carvis and Sharon. The Cardiacs, I've enjoyed it so much today, so I really appreciate you coming in. And if you want to go and see the Cardiacs on tour, are you still faded up there? I presume you are, yeah? Okay. They're playing on the 6th of November in Brighton at the Concord 2. 7th, Wedgwood Rooms in Portsmouth. 8th, Oxford Zodiac. 9th, Northampton Soundhouse. And 11th, London Astoria. Can you not crowbar a Manchester date in there? Just be a bit more convenient for me, you know.
Okay.
Right, excellent. Sorted. My kids love the Cardiacs. We're jumping around like crazy horses. Okay, that was anonymous. The Cardiacs are God, anonymous. And Lou Reed, which is anonymous. And it's not Lou Reed texting in, just when he's saying Lou Reed, but I think that's probably just a wrong answer to the question I set before, don't you? And Lou Reed is wrong anyway. All right, yes, really appreciate it. I hope you've enjoyed it.
Very much, thank you very much.
Okay, brilliant. All right then, well, the Cardiacs, everybody.